Talk to me cool, baby. There ain't a party in New York City that can beat this right here, baby. It's good music. I'm loose. I'm feeling it. Oh, yeah. This is the life, baby. This is definitely the life.
Crank it.
You miss St. Mark's.
Don't worry, baby. I'm going to swing around right here.
Crank it.
Ain't nothing but a G-thang, baby. Oh, look out. Stop honking.
Crank it up. Gonna crank it in my mind all
time.
I'm gonna crank it up, man.
Woo! Hey, man, you feel that vibe right there? Oh. You see, now that's what New Year's Eve is all about.
Crank
you can feel the fun like electricity.
Yeah! New Year's Eve is so great. It's like everyone just says, hey, man.
Baby,
I'm
you're gonna be all right back there.
Caller, you are.
Woo!
You're my friend because we, as a people, are one and we enjoy various kinds of food.
No, you know what it is? His girlfriend dumped him last night, and I think he's a little bummed.
Yeah, I'm bummed out, because now you're dragging me to some stupid fucking New Year's Eve party, and it's my birthday.
Well, happy birthday, doctor.
How perfect is that?
You didn't want to celebrate your birthday.
Crank it up, would you? Crank it.
Because I would have thrown you a party, Kevin.
I don't want a party, Lucy. I mean, you know, I want a party.
There you go.
But I just don't want a party, you know?
Oh, my God. You do this every year. Every year you do this. You ruin a perfectly good holiday with your stupid birthday bullshit.
Well, I'm sorry that it's my birthday. Believe me. I'm sorry that I was born at all.
Oh, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Oh, fuck both of y'all. That's what I say.
Fucking crank it.
Will you pull over? Pull over here, right there.
All right, baby, hold on.
Am I insane? What was I thinking? What? Do you realize I got this recipe off a box of cream cheese? Ugh, I don't even recognize myself anymore. Ugh. You know, I hate parties. I hate going to them, and I hate giving them. At least when I'm going to them, I'm not responsible for how horrible they are. And this one's gonna be the worst. I can feel it. No one's coming. No, no. The losers will be here. All the people I hate will be here. All my ex-boyfriends and their new, more attractive girlfriends will be here. Throwing a party, it's like an invitation for abuse. It's like the last desperate act of someone who hasn't had a lasting relationship since junior high.
You dated in junior high?
Why am I doing this? Why am I subjecting myself to this? God, I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, hey, man, there's no smoking in my cab, all right?
What are you talking about? You're smoking.
I smoke what you smoking.
That's great.
Hey, man, you need to relax. I mean, I've been listening to you, buddy. You way too uptight, man. You gotta look around you. Everybody's having fun out here. They drinking, they fighting, they pissing on the streets. It's New Year's Eve. They loving the ladies. You know, lady go out on New Year's Eve, she ain't trying to carry a burden, man. She trying to let one go. You wanna know how I succeed?
Not really, no.
I'm gonna tell you what I do. See, first of all, bro, you gotta smile. Like this here. Do that a lot. See, bitches love that kind of thing. They love happiness, right? Now, number two, this is very important. Don't talk about death. Everybody knows they're gonna die, baby. Nobody wanna hear from you. You dig? And number three, and this is gonna get you some booty right here. You listening? You feel me? Music makes booty spin round, baby.
This.
It's your present, fuckhead. Open it. Birthday!
There you go.
Smoke up!
All right, let's get this party rolling, baby.
Just promise we won't go past Avenue A.
How many times I gotta tell you, we're not going there.
I'm serious, Val. I know a girl who got raped on B.
Okay, okay, we're not going on B, okay?
It is so cool that we are hanging out with the bands on New Year's Eve. When are we meeting them?
I told you, after the party.
So what about this party? Are there gonna be any guys there? I mean, does your cousin know any guys?
Oh, she knows guys, but they're weird like her.
Hey.
That's okay. I like weird guys. I mean, I can get into that shit. So where's this party? Soho?
NoHo.
NoHo? I thought you said Soho.
No, I said NoHo.
That's not even a real place. They just made that up. I mean, that's not even on the map or nothing.
Well, excuse me, okay? Wherever it is, it's right up ahead.
I love the East Village. It is so cool. I mean, all the cool people live here.
Wait a minute.
What?
I thought this was the place.
This shithole?
Yeah, this is the address she gave me.
You're shitting me.
No. This is the address I wrote down.
So call her up.
I don't have a number.
What the fuck are you carrying around in that pocketbook? A fucking Encyclopedia Britannica?
I got makeup and shit in there.
Makeup and shit? Oh, well, that's just great. We're totally fucked on New Year's Eve with a pocketbook full of makeup and this shithole building address.
What should we do?
There's nothing we can do. We're fucked.
Look, I'll call and see if she's listed, all right? You got a dime?
She better be listed, Val.
A long time ago.
How long ago?
I don't know.
Well, yeah.
Maybe 6 months ago.
6 months? You think that's a long time?
Yeah, I do. I think 6 months is a considerable length of time.
Ah! Do you believe this place? Do you think 6 months is a long time to have broken up with somebody?
I guess. If it's a clean break.
I brought you some matches.
He used to go out with the slutty girl that sprung his party tonight.
You went out with her?
The only reason I said we would go is because she's afraid no one's gonna turn up.
You spoke to her?
Yes, when she invited me.
Do you think she's right about no one showing up?
Well, I'm not going.
Excuse me.
See how fun this is?
This is so fun.
Woo!
I think that bartender likes you.
Ugh. None like me likes you.
Really? Do you think so? He is dreamy, sex bomb, cute.
He's adorable. Hey, man. Hey. Man. You're a fox.
Well, sell yourself short, sir. The night's young.
He's got to be depressed working on New Year's Eve. You know what? I'm going to invite him to this party.
Everyone's depressed on New Year's Eve.
Kevin, only you are depressed on New Year's Eve. I'm having a great time, see?
The drinking, the fighting, the loving the lady.
What are you talking about?
It's the obligation to enjoy yourself. No, that's what does it. Every year it's the same desperate scrambling around. It's to round yourself with as many people as possible, go to some stupid party, pretend to be happy, when really, your girlfriend just left you and you have no career.
Are you going to be like this all night?
Yeah.
Taxi! Thanks. You. No, thanks anyway. Wait.
No. No, you go ahead and you go pick up somebody else. Okay.
Oh, excuse me, baby girl. You seem to be experiencing a little indecision.
I do?
Yeah, you have this whole ambivalent vibe radiating from your persona. Something is wrong, Mom.
I'm sorry. It's just this guy, you know?
Always is, baby.
Yeah, I was at this party, and I saw him there, and he was just so... Anyway, I ended up going home with him, and I've never done anything like that before, so now I just want everything to be perfect, you know? And I'm sorry. I don't know why I'm telling you all this.
Baby, come here for a second. Sweetheart, you know what you need to do? You need to get in this cab.
I do?
You've got to say yes to your destiny.
I do?
Yeah. Life's happening right now, baby. Look around you. Look around you. There goes some life. And over there, too. Come on, mama. Live. Live tonight. Come on in. Say yes. If you really want it. Come on.
Yes.
Say your last.
Yes.
Come on, like you feel it. Come on, baby.
Yes.
There you go. Get in this cab. Destiny awaits.
Okay.
What time is it?
Almost 8:30.
Oh.
Look, I've had it with him, and I'm not letting him push me into this old girlfriend party thing.
Absolutely not.
I mean, they only broke up like 6 months ago, right?
Please, they're practically still going out.
Too bad, in a way. He was the most successful artist I've dated this year, and he was kind of nice, you know?
Please, he was too nice. Going out with him was like, take your medicine.
And then he takes me to his gallery today to see his new show. And it sucks.
Ah! It sucks?
Yes. I can't even tell you. You wouldn't even believe his work, okay? It's like big abstract vaginas or something.
Ugh, I hate abstract. But at least he has a gallery. I mean, that's something.
Also, he's really bad in bed. He's bad in bed. He's the worst.
Oh.
Okay, so this is the address.
So you can check it out after work. I think there's gonna be a lot of people there. I mean, I'm gonna be there. With him.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I don't mean I'm with him because we're just friends and we're not together. And shit, do you think he even heard me?
It's inevitable, you know? You let somebody move in with you and you make all these little compromises to smooth things along. And the next thing you know, you're on some macrobiotic diet and you're listening to Joni Mitchell. And then you know what they say? You know what they say?
No.
They tell you you've changed. You're not the same person that I fell in love with.
Well, yeah.
And then they dump you.
What do you expect, Kevin? I mean, you go out with condescending, emasculating women. You need to find somebody that likes you the way you are.
And who would possibly like me the way that I am?
I have no idea. Now finish your drink, you know, because I want to get that guy back over here.
Where are we gonna go, huh? We don't know anybody.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll meet somebody.
What?
You know, maybe we'll meet some people.
What are you, on another fucking planet, Val? You don't just meet people on the street. I mean, even when you go to a party, you don't meet people. You just stand around talking to the ones you already know.
Yeah, we're just gonna keep walking, all right? I'll know it if I see it. It's gotta be around here somewhere. I've been there once before.
Call your mother.
My mother?
Yeah, she's got your cousin's number, don't she?
I can't call her. She thinks I'm sleeping in your house tonight.
Dad, listen to me. We are in deep shit here. I say you either call your mother for the number or we get back on a train to Ronkonkoma.
You are so uncool.
You just stay the fuck away from me.
Okay, so do you want to stop and get a drink?
I don't know, do you?
Yes, I do. It's early. I hate getting to a party before everybody else, so.
Great, okay. We can get a drink. I mean, if you want to.
Well, I don't want to force you to drink against your will. Do you want to stop or not?
Sure, if you do. Look, Jack, we don't have to do this.
I thought you said you wanted a drink.
No, I mean about going to the party.
You don't want to go to the party?
No, look, it's just, you know, it's New Year's Eve. You don't have to spend it with me. I mean, just because of...
Look, can I just say something? I'm sensing a real reluctance on your part to tell me what you would like to do tonight.
Really?
Really, and I think it's natural if we feel a little bit awkward here, you know, considering, but there's no reason why we can't just go to the party and have a good time tonight, okay?
Okay.
Okay, now, do you want to go to the party?
Sure.
All right.
If you want to.
Good. Let's get a drink.
Okay.
Nobody's coming. That's it. I have no friends and everybody hates me.
It's only 9:00.
What are they all, just walking the streets out there? Just walking the streets like zombies because it's too uncool to be prompt?
You think there's gonna be any interesting guys here tonight?
Interesting guys?
Yeah, because I think I'm finally over Lenny.
Well, congratulations, Hillary. I'm happy to hear it.
I mean, what better night to start over than New Year's Eve, right? That is, unless you're right and nobody shows up.
Well, if they do, you have my word. Any interesting guy walks through that door, he's yours.
Really?
Mm-hmm. You have first pick. I'll usher them right over to you.
Okay, but not in an obvious way. I don't want to look desperate.
Desperate? You could stand there naked with a mattress strapped to your back and still look like a Vestal Virgin.
Do you think that would work?
Where do they get these people?
You know.
Hey, loose.
I can't believe how drunk I am.
You're hiding it well.
You're right about New Year's Eve. It sucks. That bartender doesn't even know I'm alive. He has ceased refilling the peanut bowl.
Hey! Can I get some peanuts over here?
What were you two doing back there?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Do you have a light?
You were gone almost 20 minutes.
No, I mean a match.
Eric, will you relax?
Look, I've been sitting here waiting all this time. I deserve an explanation.
Thank you.
Will you get a grip?
Look, right, I got a grip. Could I have an explanation?
I'm really bad at this.
Really? I had you figured for a hardened professional. you want a break? Look, it's just a game. It's you know, it's no big deal. Relax.
Okay.
All right, here you go. Your drink.
What? Oh my God! Oh God! Excuse me. Sorry. Oh, sorry.
I got your drink.
Oh my God, Val, this is it, this is B, we're on B.
Oh, come on, we're almost there. I'm pretty sure I remember this block.
No, I'm not taking one more step.
What's the matter with you?
Val, you're crossing onto B, okay? I'm not moving from this corner.
So freeze your fucking ass off, I'm going to the party.
Something terrible is gonna happen if you cross that street, I feel it in my gut.
You get a hold of yourself? Nothing terrible is gonna happen to us. We're going to a party, is all.
Val, please listen to me. We are so lost. We are so fucked. Just please call your mother. Come on.
Okay.
Where are you going?
I gotta find a phone, don't I?
Well, there are phones on A, you know.
What's up?
We are so incredibly fucked. Val?
Oh. That's just great. That's perfect. Yeah. Look at fantastic.
It's Ellie.
Yeah, that's Ellie. Mad woman. She knew I'd be here, so she deliberately put these up. Well, you know what? It's not gonna work, Ellie. It's not gonna work because I'm doing just fine without you.
Oh, yeah, Kevin, you're doing just great.
Fuck! Oh! Ow. This is bullshit. Look, I'm just gonna go home and kill myself. You wanna share a cab?
So I can pass out and wake up alone on New Year's Day? No way, man. I'm going to this party. I've got a date.
A date?
Yep.
What, with the bartender?
Yeah, with the bartender. You should come, Kevin. You might meet somebody.
Oh, no way. I refuse to buy into the desperation to find someone just because it's New Year's Eve. It's ridiculous and demeaning.
Life is ridiculous and demeaning, Kevin. You should have sex on your birthday.
What is that, some kind of unwritten rule?
Gangway, please.
Yeah, it's a rule. In fact, forget it.
Wait, what?
Nothing.
Forget what?
Nothing.
Look, Lucy, are you offering yourself to me?
Well, no, I just thought of this thing with the bartender. Doesn't work out.
Yeah, right.
You think I'm ugly?
Well, I think you're drunk.
You think I'm ugly?
Lucy, you know I don't have ugly people for friends.
Fine. This is just, it's a waste of time. You're hell-bent on eliminating all traces of joy from this fine holiday. Hey! Oh, hey!
Wake up!
What?
What time is it?
It's 9:25.
Yeah. Why do you think they're doing this to me, Hillary?
I don't know.
I think I'm finally reaching the point of acceptance, though. I mean, about no one showing up. It's kind of liberating, in a way. Like coming face to face with your worst nightmare. You're facing death.
For Christ's sake, it's not like facing death. It's just a stupid New Year's Eve party.
You're turning on me, too.
Okay, that's it. I'm leaving.
What? What? No! No, you're my only guest! You can't leave before midnight!
I'll be back later!
No, you won't! You say you will, but you won't. Hillary, please, please, please don't leave me here all alone with the stringers and the crab dip. I can't take it!
Jesus! Do you hear yourself?
Hillary, listen. You want to meet interesting guys, right? If you stay, I'll give you Eric.
Eric? Who's Eric?
You know, Eric, my last boyfriend.
I don't believe I recall an Eric.
Hillary, Jesus, we only broke up 6 months ago.
Look, I don't remember who I was dating 6 months ago.
You remember Eric, the painter, the one with the accent. Remember when we went to a show together? He does all this big abstract paintings with the
flowers?
Yes, exactly.
He hasn't seen anyone?
Not anyone worth mentioning.
Okay, I'll do it.
You'll stay.
No, I'm still leaving. But now I'll come back.
What do you mean you'll come back? We made a deal.
I know, but I wasn't coming back before. Now I will.
But no, that's not our deal. Our deal is you're not supposed to leave.
Are you breaking up with me? I don't know what to say. I thought everything was fine.
Look, to tell you the truth, I'm still in love with my old boyfriend.
He's French-Canadian.
Yeah, and I met him while I was camping.
I don't believe this.
We didn't even officially break up. He just disappeared while we were on a mountain climbing trip.
We all thought he was dead.
But he called this morning, so...
So he just called you up out of the blue, just called you up to say, hi, how are you? I'm not dead.
That's right.
Yeah,
Well, that's the most ridiculous story I've ever heard in my entire life.
Eric, Jesus, Eric, would you...
And what kind of woman are you anyway, just blurting it out like this, in the street, on New Year's Eve?
I'm sorry.
Oh, you're sorry?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you better be sorry, sweetheart, because you're the one that has to live with this, not me. You're the one inventing old boyfriends and bringing them back from the dead.
Yeah.
And you, with your sordid little agenda. Well, oh, I've had it with you. You deserve each other.
I don't believe this.
Oh, my God.
Do you believe him?
Really?
Do you believe him?
Like, it's your fault he's bad in bed.
There's no answer.
Oh, my God, there's no answer? What the fuck is your mother doing not answering her phone?
I don't know. Maybe she went to a party or something.
Oh, my God.
Well, maybe she's just down the laundry room. Well, what the fuck are we supposed to do? Hang out for the rinse cycle or something?
I don't know. All right, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna call this band and tell them we're meeting them early, all right? End of story.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I just can't, all right?
Oh, my God. There is no band, is there?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you, the liar, who's been bragging for months about how we're gonna meet this band on New Year's Eve in New York City. When there ain't no bands, there ain't no nothing.
Well, it's the only way I could get you to come into this city with me.
I bet your cousin isn't even having a party, is she?
She is having a party. I just need the address. All right, look. We'll go in here, we'll get a couple beers, and I'll try again later.
We don't belong in there, Val. We don't belong on B. We're in way over our heads here.
Steffi, we got money. We got fake IDs. From where I'm standing, we got just as much right to be in there as anybody else.
Oh, my God.
What? What's the matter?
It's those guys. It's those guys. They're definitely following us.
Are they cute?
Val, I'm just saying.
All right, come on. Let's go.
You know what? I can't even tell you how many men I fucked.
I believe you.
I couldn't even make a list anymore. That's how many there are.
Lucy, I believe you fucked many, many men, okay?
A lot more than Ellie.
You drop this
that's
now, please.
For sure. She's too busy being expressive and making trivial performance art to attract anybody but you. And Jack, of course.
What?
Well, Jack will fuck anybody.
Ellie and Jack? When did that happen?
I don't know, 3 weeks ago, a month.
Recently? While we were still together? Why didn't you tell me?
Kevin, I thought you knew. Everybody knew.
Apparently not everyone. I can't believe this.
It must be part of the whole Zelda thing. The whole, you know, high-strung, tempestuous, castrating, bitch from hell, make my life miserable persona.
You know, this is turning out to be the worst birthday ever. I wasn't expecting much, but this is an unprecedented low.
Don't try to make me feel sorry for you. Don't even start. Because I'm so sick of your shit tonight. You know what, Kevin? We're going to that party. We're going to that party, and we're going to have fun, whether you like it or not. And you know what? You better pray that the bartender shows up.
Wow, that was pretty embarrassing. I mean, that was awful. The pool table, the lamp and everything.
It's okay, I never planned on going back there again anyway, so.
Jack, maybe I should just go home.
If that's what you want, okay, I'll call you a cab.
We could do it again another time.
Absolutely, sure.
You know, when there isn't so much pressure.
Pressure?
Yeah, you know, big New Year's Eve date thing. And plus, I've never really done the kind of thing I did last night.
Taxi! God damn it.
What? As a matter of fact, I never really did it at all.
Did what?
You know, it.
It, you never did it.
Oh, well, no.
You're kidding me. Why didn't you tell me?
I guess I was afraid you were gonna think I was some kind of freak or something.
So what you're saying is that I was your first?
Yeah.
First. Like, I was the first guy that you ever let
Yeah.
Ever?
Yeah. Yes.
Wow.
You're embarrassing me, Jack.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I'm stunned. This has never happened to me before.
Well, now you know how I feel.
But why me? I mean, we hardly knew each other.
You know, I don't really feel comfortable talking about this.
No, that's okay. I understand. God, you must be freezing. What am I doing? Let me get you inside. Are you hungry?
What? You don't want me to go home?
No. Don't go home. Stay. Let's get some food in you, and then we'll go to the party later, together.
You sure?
I'm really sure. Come on, I know this great little Indian place nearby. You like Indian?
Well, sure. I mean, if you do.
This is where it is. It's supposed to be a good party. You guys should come by. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
We will.
Yeah. Go on.
Yeah, okay. It's almost 10, and, we've got to get dates.
What about you?
Please, it's just too desperate getting picked up by some bartender.
Some bartender? What are you? You're a waitress.
Excuse me. I'm an artist.
Okay, so maybe he's an artist, too.
Believe me, he's not an artist. Will you just forget about him? We still have 2 whole hours.
Caitlin, I know a girl who went home alone on New Year's Eve. It was like she was jinxed for the whole year. 12 months, completely invisible to guys. It was like she was tainted.
We'll get dates. When have we ever not gotten dates?
Not me. Remember, 78, I went home alone?
You were in a committed monogamous relationship that week.
There was no committed monogamous relationship. That was a cover story.
Hi.
I forgot my key.
Jenny, I'm sorry.
Don't. Love means never having to say you're sorry.
Hate you, motherfuckers. Oh my God. Guess.
Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you. Coming! Eric, hi! Happy New
Year.
Great party.
Oh, come on, Eric. You know how it is. No one wants to be the first to arrive, that's all. How about some food? You want some food? I made the crab dip myself. So, where's what's-her-face?
She's not coming.
Oh, she's not?
She broke up with me. Do you believe that? It's New Year's Eve, and the woman breaks up with me. And wait till you hear the story she came up with. Suddenly, she's got this mountain-climbing boyfriend that everyone thought was dead. But now it turns out he's alive. Have you ever heard such a pile of shite?
Well, you know how it is. You know, we need some music, don't you think? Something Christmassy, huh?
I hate Christmas.
Jesus, Eric, help me out here, okay? I'm hanging on by a thread.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
My God. Stop yourself. Look, I hate the holidays. I hate the way they're all bunched together. And I think the whole thing stinks. It's all bullshit.
Hey, can we get some beers over here? Oh my God, Val, we have to go.
Gee, hold on a minute, I'm trying to get a beer.
Val, it's those guys, it's them, they're coming over here.
Oh God, those are them?
Come on. Oh shit, move it. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Hurry up.
Over there, there's the door, come on.
Jesus, Kathy. God.
Oh, hey. How you doing? Wow, it's kind of hot in there, huh? We thought we'd come out here and get some air and just take this opportunity to introduce ourselves. My name's Tom. This is Dave. And hey, man. No manners. Show the ladies what we got for them, bro. Hmm. Beverages? Here.
Jack, you're doing it again.
I'm sorry. It's just, you know, what can I say? This is turning out to be a pretty unusual evening.
Unusual? How?
Well, unusual in no particular way. Look, Cindy, I hate to press a point here, but I keep thinking about what you said earlier about last night being your first time and everything.
What about it?
Well, I wonder, you know, why me? You know, what was it about me in particular? Okay, being specific, that made you decide to, you know.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Right. Let's see, why did I choose you? Drawing a blank.
That's okay. Drawing a, they say blanks are look, as an actor, Cindy, I find myself very intrigued by people's motivations. Mm-hmm. Look, you're a very attractive girl. You must have had lots of opportunities.
Especially as pretty as you are, I'm surprised it hasn't happened by accident. So a guy has to wonder.
What makes him so great?
Well, one thing I remember about last night was...
Yes?
That you were probably the most...
The most what?
Oh, God.
You okay? Here, drink some water.
Oh, God.
Drink it. Here, that'll make it worse. Have some wine. Is it better? Probably at one of those chilies.
No, it was so big.
Try to keep it in your mouth.
It was so big. I thought it was okra.
Oh, okra's brown. Well, are you okay?
Fine. Ew.
Ew.
I'll be okay.
It's all right.
I'll be right back.
That is fine. No problem. It happens here every night.
Most what?
No, I'm not going to shut up. I have a right to know. I have a right to know why you won't fuck me, Kevin.
Lucy, do you want to fuck? Because if you really, really want to fuck, well, fuck, okay?
You don't think I'm serious.
How long have we known each other? Look, in the 5 years that we've known each other, have you once even ever considered having sex with me? I mean, apart from tonight.
You don't think I'm attracted to you.
I don't think you're attracted to half the men you sleep
with. You think I'm a slut.
What? No.
Yeah, you think I'm a big slut.
I don't think you're a slut. A stanky little hoe, maybe, but never a slut.
The truth is, you're afraid.
What? I'm afraid. Okay. I feel so naked right now. I'm totally afraid.
It's so obvious.
It's so ridiculous.
Yeah. Prove it.
I don't have to prove anything.
I dare you. Kevin, I dare you to fuck me.
What? So what, now? You want to go to some smelly bathroom and have loveless New Year's sex in the stench of air freshener?
Unless you're chicken.
So we gotta go back to the club to deliver this package to my friend Tony. Is that cool?
Yeah, it's cool.
So, what's in this package anyway?
It's like I said, it's for my friend Tony.
Oh, yeah? It's for Tony? All right. Well, I'm leaving.
Where are you going?
I'm going to the train station to get out of here before these jerks get us killed.
You wanted to hang out with the bands, right? These guys are musicians.
They're roadies, Val. There's a little difference.
Look, I didn't want to have to tell you this, because I know you're gonna spaz out. But the last train for Onkonkoma left an hour ago.
Are you telling me we're stranded here for the night?
So we got a book. You coming?
Yeah, we're coming.
Caitlin, I'm warning you. Keep your slutty hands off my bartender.
He's not your bartender. He's our bartender.
Caitlin, your skirt's been over your head for hours.
Jesus, like it's my fault. I'm irresistible to man.
Look, he wants me. Not you, me.
You think so?
Yeah, I do think so.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
So listen, I think it's still a little bit early for this party. What do you say we go get some cocktails?
For some reason, every single woman I go out with ends up breaking up with me. I mean, why is that, Monica?
I don't know. Lots of reasons, probably.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it's always lots of reasons. I've never had a straight answer out of one of you. Like you. What was your reason?
Really, Eric, who remembers?
You don't remember? It was only 6 months ago.
Well, 6 months is a long time.
No, 6 months is nothing.
Jesus, Eric, relax.
Okay, fine. You don't remember the lame excuse you gave me 6 months ago for breaking up with me. I'll tell you. You like me as a friend, but not as a boyfriend, even though you found me attractive.
That's not lame.
It makes no sense whatsoever.
I think it makes sense.
See? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I have to deal with. These insane leaps of reasoning. And they sound logical at first. Until later. Until you go home, sit down, and think about them. And then it's like, what?
Really, Eric, you just gotta calm down.
Look, all I'm asking for is the truth. If you want to break up with me, fine. Just tell me the reason why. Is that too much to ask? I'm stupid.
What are you doing?
I'm going home.
But you just got here. Eric, please, please don't do this. Please don't go.
Okay, fine. I won't go home. Tell me the truth and I'll stay.
What?
Tell me the real reason you broke up with me and I'll stay.
Okay, 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 okay. I'll do it. Oh, God. I can't speak for Bridget or any of the others.
Fine.
But for me, just for me. The truth is, I broke up with you because you were the worst lover I ever had in my life.
What?
I'm serious. Even counting high school, it was bad.
Ow.
What are you doing?
Dress.
Well, what's wrong with it?
Zipper stuck.
Oh my God, I'm sorry.
Damn, baby.
Ow!
Oh.
All right, you okay?
I'm fine. We're just having fun.
Someone's coming.
Kevin? Hello, Kevin. I recognize your shoes. I bought them for you, remember?
Oh. Ellie.
That's perfect. Good for you.
That's perfect.
What are you doing here?
I was contemplating using the bathroom, asshole.
This is such an incredible coincidence, huh? Isn't this an incredible coincidence?
It's incredible.
It is incredible.
Weird.
I can't believe it. 24 hours ago, you were so heartbroken, and now you're throwing yourself at her?
Her? We're just friends. You remember Lucy?
Why did you have to bring her to our coffee shop?
It's not what you think.
You know what? It doesn't even matter what I think.
No, wait, where are you going?
Off, off, off to call my therapist.
You can't call your therapist on New Year's Eve.
I'm staying at his place.
Oh, so you're shacking up with him?
No, I'm not shacking up with him. I'm staying there till I find a new apartment.
Wasn't there enough room at Jack's?
What are you talking about?
No, I just happened to hear a whole story about how you and Jack were sleeping with each other the entire time we were going out.
Stop it. You're insane. I've never slept with Jack.
What?
I have never slept with Jack. I don't believe you. You know, I just left a message on your machine saying I wanted to move back in. That's so pathetic. I thought, you know what? Enjoy. Enjoy.
But baby!
No, don't move a baby. Okay, so I was wrong about Jack.
Jack?
Hi.
Cheryl.
Cheryl, right.
I can't believe you don't remember my name.
What are you talking about? Cheryl. I just said Cheryl. So how are things?
You said you were going out of town for New Year's Eve.
Really? I said that? That's funny. I don't remember saying that.
You said you'd be gone all week.
Oh, I did say that. You know what happened is my ski trip. I was supposed to go on a ski trip and it got canceled.
You said you were flying to L.A. to audition for a sitcom?
I did.
I can't believe I was stupid enough to care about you, Jack.
Cheryl.
Just do me a favor. Don't call me again. Okay?
Jerk.
Good to see you too, Cheryl. Happy New Year. Hi. It's my friend. Hey, pal, did you see, right. Cindy, you okay in there?
I'm just fine. Great, Jack.
Part number me tundur ini kaya. Hello.
Okay. It's, I know. Cindy, please, we're making a scene. Could you come out of there now?
Yeah.
You about ready to go? Because I think I'd really like to get out of here, like, right now. Cindy!
I'm coming!
Please, Cindy. Look, I'm sorry I yelled at you. For reasons I can't explain right now, I need you to come out of the bathroom. Come out. Oh my God. You look like you're about to throw up or something.
I know, I look terrible.
No, that's not what I meant. I mean, look, so what? You ate a chili. It's no big deal.
Yeah, sure, you say that now, but tomorrow it's gonna be another story. You know, tomorrow's gonna be, oh no, there's that chili girl calling me again.
Come on, you don't know what's gonna happen.
I just wanted everything to be perfect because, Jack, I really think you're the most, I just think you're so...
What? What?
I just think you're a really nice person, Jack.
You think I'm nice?
You are nice. I remember last night when I got the nosebleed at the party. You know, most guys wouldn't even look at me after something like that. Most guys.
Why don't we take this outside?
What?
Well, let's just talk, but outside in...
Oh, okay.
Not in... No, here, come on. Let's go. No. This way. I paid the check already. I got your coat, your glove.
Ow! She got the day you decide she'll take a tumble on you. Roll you like you would
Hey, guys.
Here we go. This is your... Can you tell I'm professional?
Jeez. Happy New Year.
82.
Rock on.
So, no, to answer the unspoken question, I won't be serving my Italians my whole life.
Tell me about it. I'm a secretary.
That's nothing. I'm a waitress.
That's great.
What would you rather be doing?
Well, I'm in my third year of law school.
Law school?
So.
You're kidding. You mean you're not an artist?
No, as a matter of fact, I'm not kidding. My dad's a lawyer, and, turns out I picked up a little bit of a knack for the thing off the old man, and, I mean, that's only what I want to do, you know, short term, before I get out and play the market full time. Huh. That and buying and selling converted co-op properties. Condos is something that I'm going to get into. You know, you got to ride this wave. This is Reaganomics. It's the time to invest. Prime the pump. I'm kind of nervous. Can you tell? It's the first time I've ever been on a date with two girls. It's kind of cool. Do you guys like to dance, or do you like Devo, or what? You know what? I mean, those outfits really feature you guys well. They're really sexy. My clothes and those clothes would look good on my floor. Seriously. By the way, how do you like your eggs in the morning? Scrambled or fertilized? No, I'm kidding. That's a joke.
I can't believe I'm letting you drag me back into this skank pit.
I gotta go find Tony.
Yeah, okay.
Alright.
I can't believe he let me fight you. Will you grow up already? Hey, I thought you were giving that package to your friend.
Yeah, he went to a party in Avenue D. We'll have to go meet him there.
What? Cool.
Wanna dance?
Yeah, come on. Did you say D? D like cool?
I mean, we're not talking physical oddity here, right? I mean, the dimensions that we're speaking of, they're well within the standard range of normal human proportions.
It's not that.
Oh, the time I fell asleep. Woman, I was tired. I mean, I'm only human for Christ's sake.
It wasn't that either, okay?
Well, what then? What was so horrible that you never even gave me a chance? I mean, a person can make progress, you know. I mean, there's techniques you can learn and books you can buy.
No, I don't think that would have helped.
So I'm hopeless. That's it. I'm hopeless.
You still have your work.
Oh, my work, my work. Of course, thank you. Thank you. I feel fantastic now.
Eric, look, some things just can't be helped, you know?
Yep, I understand. You bring me over here and you tell me I'm the worst lover you ever had, and now you tell me it can't be helped.
Look, I'm sorry that What's-Her-Face dumped you, okay? And I'm sorry that you're so bad in bed. I really am. Most of all, I'm sorry that I decided to throw this atrocity, this nightmarish ordeal of a New Year's party, because this is breaking me, Eric. Do you understand me? This party is breaking me.
You don't have to get so emotional. He's not that bad.
He's not that bad. It's not that bad. Eric, we are standing here with one hostess who's on the verge of hysteria and one guest who spent the entire evening coming to terms with his sexual problems, okay? That's it. That's my party. Happy fucking New Year.
How could I have been so stupid? Of course Ellie's gonna show up tonight, given it's the worst possible thing that could happen. I'm never gonna forgive you for this, Lucy.
It's not my fault your girlfriend caught us making out in a bathroom stall. You know, I didn't hear any complaints when your hands were up my dress.
You know, this is a big joke to you, but this is my life. You don't understand.
You should be thanking me for helping you sever a totally unhealthy relationship.
Thanking you? My life is totally screwed up now because of you.
Your life has been totally dark, evil, and nihilistic since the day I've met you. It never gets any better. You're so depressed, Kevin. The only reason I keep you around as my friend is because you make my life look great by comparison.
Oh, thank you. What a humanitarian. Your life's a rose.
Maybe I should leave.
Maybe you should. Where are you going?
To find that bartender.
The bartender? Well, that's just perfect. Give him my regards.
I will. Fuck you!
Fuck you! Just remember, I was the one that wanted to stay home tonight, Lucy!
Nothing. I just, Hey, you okay over there?
Wow.
Okay, let's go now.
I guess I was wrong about tonight turning out to be so terrible.
Yeah, maybe, yeah, but let's just go to the party, okay?
No, Jack, I mean, I think I'm falling in love with you.
What?
I mean, I think I'm in love with you.
Oh, not again.
What do you mean, not again?
Look, don't do this, okay? Just don't do this. You don't even know me.
But I like you, and I thought you liked me.
Yeah, I do like you. I like you a lot, but I like a lot of people, see?
I see.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. Look, Cheryl.
Cindy! My name is Cindy!
Right, I know, I'm sorry.
Who's Cheryl?
It doesn't matter.
But you're in love with a Cheryl person?
No, I'm not in love with anybody. That's the point. The whole topic makes me uncomfortable. Look, let's just forget everything and we'll go to the party. Okay, come on, go to the party with me. Be careful on the ice.
I wouldn't go to that party with you if you were the last man on
Earth. Come on, don't do this, Cindy.
Oh, go to hell.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, God.
You all right?
No, I think I landed in a big pile of dog shit. Ew.
Ew.
Oh, God, I'm so embarrassed.
It's not that bad, really. It's not that bad.
Oh, leave me alone. Jesus, I hate you. You're just such a big phony. It's like you're not nice at all.
I never said I was nice. You're the one that kept going on all night about how nice I was.
Oh, you're so conceited.
What are you talking about?
Don't you think I haven't noticed? I mean, ever since you found out I was a virgin before last night, you've been hounding me for a reason. Why? Why did I choose you? What was it about you? You, that's all you care about.
I was curious.
Listen, you think there was something special about you? Well, guess what? It could have been anybody. Yeah, that's right. You were just there. I would have gone home with anybody last night. I just wanted to get it over with. Could have been anybody.
Okay, date's over. Look, why don't we just end this date right here, okay?
That's fine with me.
We'll both go home, and if we're lucky, we'll never have to see each other again.
Sounds perfect.
Great. You want to share a cab?
Fine. Bet that Cheryl person hates you too.
Yeah, her and every other woman in New York. Taxi!
So common, so typical, so similar. You men are so similar in your mediocrity. You're like a pack of Philistines.
These matches are disappointing me.
Here you go, baby.
I can't be baby, but thank you. You see what I did? I said thank you. That's courtesy. And courtesy and manners are what women know. Men, you get in a relationship, and the woman is so willing to sublimate her needs to guide her man through the important signposts of life, lovingly, very lovingly. And then you turn your back for 24 hours, and you go into a public restroom, and there he is, making out with another woman. Do you see what I'm saying? And it's like, who do I have to blame? I have myself to blame because I've dated enough narcissistically neurotic men to know that you are all just a pack of roving babies in search of a giant teat from which to suck the lifeblood out of me till I'm a hollow shell. What?
Well, baby, all this talk about teats just made me think I should say something. I'm sensing a lot of hostility coming from the back seat.
Oh, really? That's very astute.
Well, that's not good for me, man. I mean, that kind of energy damages the plush interior of my cab, right? And you're blowing a $5 high, mama. You need to find yourself a man who's secure enough to appreciate you for the superior woman that you are. Now, I like a strong woman.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you are a strong woman. And if I was you, I would pull over with me and celebrate our strength together. What do you think about that, baby?
This corner's great. Oh. This corner's fantastic for me.
Well, let's do that. I know you want to pull over so soon, but I tell you what. You want to make slow, passionate love, or should I leave the meter running? Baby, baby. Baby, action left. Mm. Let me see. Did I smile? I must not have smiled. That's what it was.
That was a total waste of time.
Really? Law school? That is so yuppie.
Do you believe I'm going on about real estate all night?
What is it with guys where they think you give a shit about their stuff? There he is.
You think this is too mean, ditching him this way?
Please. The law school thing is bad enough, but what's with the cowboy shirt and the gladiator hair?
Really? Oh, and you might want to try a new approach. This whole thing with the matchbooks is so predictable.
Well, what do you expect? I'm under a deadline.
What time is it anyway?
Oh my God.
What?
We've got an hour.
An hour? Are you serious?
Come on, wait a minute.
About this world, I don't care. About that girl, I don't care.
It's all in the technique. Most people, they underestimate the importance of the rotational thrust.
Eric, you're hurting my skin.
Ah, well, that's just great.
Ow!
You know, I don't think I'm the one with the problem here, Monica. I think it's you. I think you're blaming me for being bad in bed because you're clearly stunted in some way physically.
It's not my fault you're an emotional cripple.
But you, well, that's so typical of a woman. It's all about emotions and intimacy and feelings and all that vague, ambiguous bullshit. It's sex. That's it. Two people in a bed getting off. Not some ethereal thing out there to embrace humanity.
Look, you wanted to know why you were bad in bed, and I told you. You don't have to bite my head off just because you're inadequate.
Oh, now I'm inadequate?
Mm-hmm.
You think I'm inadequate?
Yeah.
Well, you just take that god-awful dress off, and I'll show you who's adequate, honey.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna prove you wrong. That's right. I'm gonna have you on your hands and knees begging for mercy.
Oh my God! Are you insane?
Jesus, there's nobody here yet?
Eric's here.
Eric. Right. Hi. Hi, I'm Hillary. You know, I just love your flowers.
My what?
Your flowers.
Jesus, you scared me half to death.
Oh, there.
What are you still doing with that package? I thought we were getting out of here already.
Yeah, well, Tony's not here yet, so we'll just stick around and see if he shows up.
Great.
Man, it's a cool party, huh?
It's retarded. I want to leave.
Well, yeah, well, where do you want to go?
Ronkonkoma.
What?
You know, Ronkonkoma. Yeah, well, it's on Long Island.
Long Island, huh? I'm from Jersey.
Congratulations.
Yeah. So, can I ask you a question?
From the country.
Well, did Val say something to you about me? Because I felt like we were really hitting it off there for a while. I mean, felt like she really liked me, you know, and now she's in there making out with Dave, and I'm just wondering, I mean, did I do something to offend her?
You know how it is.
Yeah. It's like when I first met Val, though, you know, I was like, whoa, this is the one. This is the one. Because the thing about Val is, you know, she's different. I mean, you know, she's just like this little girl, and I wanted to get near her, you know, and I wanted to be with her, you know, her big eyes, and that just, her big round head, you know, just thought maybe, I was falling in. I mean, you know, maybe this is, I don't know, I mean, all right, you probably think this is really jerky, huh? Saying something just because I just met her.
Look, can I tell you something here? Because this is like the worst night of my life, okay? I mean, I'm standing here in a basement on fucking Avenue D. So I'm sorry if you're having troubles finding the right girl and everything, but I'm just trying to get the fuck home before somebody kills me, all right?
All right. Yeah, I can see that.
Please, don't let this feeling end. It may not come again, and I want to remember how it feels to touch you, how I feel so much.
You some flowers. Mind if I sit down?
I'm with someone.
What? You're with someone?
You understand.
With a bartender?
He's in the bathroom. He's gonna be right back. You know what? You should just go home. That's what you wanted to do. Just go home and don't worry about me because I'm set for the night.
Look, you just met this guy.
So?
So, don't you think it seems a little sudden or something to be going?
You are much more judgmental between girlfriends. Have you ever noticed that, Kevin?
Oh, fine, all right. You want to throw yourself at some guy you just met? Uh-huh. It's your business. I'm going home.
Oh. Thanks.
Okay, look.
What?
The thing is, what I want to say, what I'm...
Yes. Yes, Kevin.
Let's do it.
What?
I think we should do it.
You gotta be kidding.
I'm serious. I think we should go back to the coffee shop and just do it. What do you say? Come on, Yin.
You know what? I can't just leave the bartender.
It's my birthday. We're practically obligated to do it. You said so yourself. Come on. I dare you. I dare you to fuck me.
Bell to ring. Deep
thing. Take no big thing. Told the bitch.
Do you mean to tell me she actually broke up with you on New Year's Eve?
I was flabbergasted.
Well, obviously she was threatened by you creatively. Your work is so brilliant, it's so powerful.
You think so?
Oh, absolutely. What other reason could there be?
See, I've always been fascinated by the female form.
Oh, huh?
Well, take you, Hillary. You would make a wonderful artist model. You have an almost perfect symmetry.
I've been working out.
Oh, I can see that. You really seem to understand my thrust.
I guess I do.
I can't believe I almost went home earlier.
I feel exactly the same way. Can I get you another drink?
Hillary, you should come down to this studio and take a look at my work before my next show.
Hillary, I mean, work.
Great!
Taxi! Oh, great. Just drive right past me like I'm not even here. Look, can I just say something?
I'm not speaking to you, Jack.
Well, I think you'll feel a little better if you hear me out. Look, what happened between us last night is like this ongoing problem with me. It happens all the time. I meet someone, we go home together, but then the next day it's...
What? Next day what?
Well, they tell me that suddenly they've developed these feelings for me.
What are you saying? That every woman you go home with falls in love with you or something?
Yes! It's like a curse. It never ends.
A woman falls in love with you and you think that's a curse?
You have no idea.
No, I don't. Because I think you're lucky. I mean, there are some people who wait their entire lives for somebody to tell them they feel that way about them. And you just throw it away like it's nothing. Like it's a minor inconvenience. Well, let me tell you something, Jack. You are cursed. Just not the way you think you are.
Well, then how?
Goodbye, Jack.
Where are you going?
Taxi!
Cindy, wait. You can't leave. You got dog shit on your back. Your dress! Fuck me.
Will you hurry up? There's gotta be a cab around here somewhere.
I can't go on.
Listen to you, listen to me! I'm getting to that party, do you understand me? It's my only hope thanks to you.
Excuse me?
I know it's not much, but at least Eric will be there.
Eric?
Oh, you want Eric? Fine, I'll take the bartender, lawyer, real estate guy.
Taxi!
Okay. We're leaving!
He's all yours.
Get away from me!
We have an emergency. 292 Great Jones Street.
Oh, you know, baby, you better tell me that when we get moving. I'm a little intoxicated. It's New Year's Eve.
I can't believe that you were so hard up that you'd go for that lawyer.
Oh, I suppose now you want him for yourself, huh?
You are so paranoid.
Oh, maybe you want Eric and the lawyer. Is that it?
Hey!
But please don't touch me. Too much hostility.
Can you just get the car to move?
We know, baby, in life, sometimes you gotta stay still to move forward.
What?
Would you like a cigarette? Yeah, come on. Here you go. You know, this song always reminds me of me and my buddy Twain. Twain was my best friend a few years back, till we fell in love with the same girl. Pretty girl, foxy. Anyway, Twain was a smooth one. You know, I was a shy little knucklehead kid. I had no afro back then, so you know, I wasn't smooth. Anyway, one night I went to a restaurant, bump into Twain and the girl of my dreams eating dinner. I sat in the back of the restaurant watching me dinner all goddamn night. First they had a little finger food. Wine, cheese, the whole thing. And the whole time I'm sitting over there, I said, I wish that was me. Next thing I know, Twain biting to a string bean and choked to death right in the middle of the goddamn restaurant. I always thought it could have been me, it should have been me. Song always make me think about that. Silky Ho, I'll never forget her.
So what are you saying, love kills?
No. He's saying we shouldn't fight about these guys. And personally, I think he's right.
Oh, I know I'm right, baby.
What if, for the sake of our friendship, we just decided to leave the party alone tonight?
You mean no guys at all?
That sounds much better, doesn't it?
You mean we go home alone, no guys at all, even if it means we get jinxed for the whole year.
That's the kind of sacrifice I'm willing to make for a friendship.
Okay.
What's happening in this cab right now is beautiful. It's beautiful.
Is there any way that you can get this car to just move?
Is there any way you can get out the car and move that truck for me?
Kevin, don't. Just stop it.
What's wrong?
I don't know. I opened my eyes and I saw your face and I realized I can't do this.
What? You just saw my face and realized you can't have sex with me?
I can't go on forever having sex with people who don't care about me.
And you just realized this now?
Yeah.
So all the years of empty, meaningless sex with countless strangers and bartenders, that's great, that's fine. But here, now, with me, and bam, you have an epiphany and you realize you can't do it anymore?
Don't yell at me, Kevin.
You're fucked up, you know?
I'm fucked up? I mean, what do you call somebody who throws himself into one doomed relationship after the next when he could be with...
What? When I could be with what?
Yeah. I can't go on. This guy weighs a fucking ton. I knew we should have left him behind.
Hold on. We're almost there.
Are you kidding? We're not almost there. Did you guys hear those gunshots?
Just get him into a cab.
You can't just put him in a cab. He ain't conscious.
Oh, aren't we concerned?
Look, he'll be all right, okay? We'll pay the driver and give him the address. Does he got any money on him?
Yeah, and his wallet.
I'm not finding the wallet here.
Wait a minute. Here it is.
Hey, there's no money in here. Oh, well, that's just great. I told you we should have left him behind.
Steffi, please. I can't take it anymore. All you do is complain.
I mean, Steffi, have you ever thought to look on the bright side of things? Huh? Did you ever think that maybe you could have a good time if you just shut your freaking mouth for 5 seconds? Oh, I mean, nothing is good enough for you.
Oh, my God.
What?
This is the address I wrote down for my cousin's party.
You're shitting me.
No way. This is totally the right address.
Thank you, God. We're going to the party. Come on.
Come on.
Hey,
I'll catch up with you later.
now. Jesus. Hi, hi, puppy. Good dog. Good dog.
Hey. Wake up.
Huh? Who the fuck are you?
I live here. Who the fuck are you?
Oh, you're Monica. Hi, I'm Steffi. I'm a friend of your cousin Val's.
My cousin Val? From Ronkonkoma?
Yeah. She brought me here last night. Oh, God, I'm so hungover. I can't believe it.
My cousin Val from Ronkonkoma was here last night?
Yeah, her and about a million other people.
Well, that's great. That's just great. Everybody came and I missed it.
This is so cool. Oh, and I called my parents and they want you to come over for dinner tonight.
What?
No, it's cool, because I told them I slept on the sofa, so you won't get in trouble for anything.
Trouble? How old are you exactly? You know, because you looked a lot older last night.
Oh, will you relax? I'm not telling no one. It'll be our little secret, like Romeo and Juliet.
Oh, my God.
You know, there's a reason why I don't mind lying to my parents. You want to know what it is?
I bet I know.
I bet you don't.
Yeah.
I love you.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's really cool, too, because we can spend every weekend together. And then in June, you can come to my prom. Shit, my friends are gonna be so jealous. 1982 is gonna be like the coolest year ever. Oh, God!
Oh, you love that!
Was it?
No. Oh, yeah. It was great.
I know.
Oh, geez. Will you look at the time?
So, do you want to get together later?
Oh, yeah, sure, if I have time.
If you have time?
Well, you know, I just started working at this gallery, and it's kind of all-consuming right now, but if I have time, you know.
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, Hillary, no, I don't know.
The band? What band? There were actual musicians here? At my house, playing at my party? Here? At my party?
Yeah. You know, I never heard of them, but that don't mean much. This guy with funny glasses? Elvis something?
Elvis Costello?
Yeah, that's who it was. Yeah, I heard he had a record out.
Oh. Elvis Costello? The love of my life? Was here? At my house, singing in my party?
Yeah. He was going on and on about the crab dip, asking around for the recipe. Nobody had it.
It was off the box. I could have told him that.
Look, just tell me one thing. I'm not a vain person. Was the sex any good at all?
No, I'm sorry, it was bad.
Hello?
Hey, so are you totally hungover?
No, I think I'm still drunk.
Ugh, that's the worst.
So what'd you think about that party last night?
Did you believe that lawyer bartender guy showed up?
He wasn't so bad. I mean, he was really nice about us ditching him and all that.
Are you crazy? What a disappointing party. Those guys were such total posers. I'm so glad we decided to go home alone.
Oh.
Wanna go for breakfast?
No, maybe lunch?
Oh,
I gotta go.
Hey.
Guess who reloaded, baby?
Give it to me, give it to me. Give it to me, give it to me. Give me a snack.
I mean, at least they showed up, right? I mean, at least I don't have to spend the rest of my life thinking I have no friends and everybody hates me, right? That's something, right?
Yeah. Listen, do you got any Alka-Seltzer? I gotta meet this guy Tony for breakfast.
It's in the bathroom.
Thanks.
Can I call you later?
You mean like later today?
Yeah, unless you think that's too jerky. Is that too jerky or something?
No, I don't think it's too jerky.
You don't?
Uh-uh.
Okay, good, you know. Because, you know, I really like you a lot. You know, I like you a lot.
You do?
Yeah. I mean, I don't think that you need a lot of time to know something like that. You know, you just, you know, when you know it, you know, when it happens, you know it. And I know it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, so do I.
So, we should go to dinner tonight? You want to?
Okay.
You're gonna think this is crazy, but I think I'm falling in love with you.
No, I don't think you're crazy.
Hey, man, you smell dog shit?
Did you know that cigarettes are a shield against meaningful interaction with other people? It's true. I read it. People protect themselves emotionally by relating to their cigarettes instead of each other.
What struck me last night watching all those people standing around with their cigarettes. Why is everyone so afraid? Why are people so scared of each other?
Like us?
We've never been anything but totally honest with each other. Them.
Anyway, I think it's time to quit smoking.
So then you'll get grumpy and cranky and fat and you'll whine and you'll bitch and you'll lose all your inspiration and then
Oh no, I went to a crazy New Year's Eve party. After I put the cab up, I mean. I got pictures, look here. Now these two girls in this picture, I couldn't understand a damn thing they said. And where in the hell is Ron Cacamano? Now this guy here, he's a famous necrophiliac with an alp. He kept dragging a dead girl around the party. It was real weird. Look at his eyes, man. He's crazy. Look at her. Dead, dead, dead. This dude right here I call Vagina Puppet Man because he kept making vagina puppets with his hands. But he's a real talented fella. I mean, I see big things in his future because there's a market for vaginas. This girl right here keeps feeding people little weenies, but I think she want a weenie herself, if you know what I'm saying. Now this little girl here, I picked her up earlier that night too. It's a small city, ain't it? That must be the guy she was telling me she was so nervous about being with. Just when he started to make a little headway, wouldn't you know, one of the ugliest bitches I've ever seen in my life rolled up. And I'm not one to call women ugly, but I think this woman was because she had a penis. Oh, there's Dutch boy with the girl from Rancakamano. I ain't gonna call her young, but I'm gonna tell you this. I bet you she write a couple love letters and crayons here and there. There I go. I'm having fun right here. I was having fun. And here go my man right here. Remember him? This guy would not listen to me, man. He got two girls. Don't know what to do with either of them. You see, big girl right here wasn't having that. She got into it with little girl right there. And next thing I know, he's rolling with big girl. But dig this, right? Little girl scored with a necrophiliac. Thank God it brought a live one home, if you know what I'm saying. Now this guy is hungry for love or something. And then who walks over for my little girl pretty in pink? And it looks like it found what it wanted. That is, until her nose started bleeding. Then they was hugging, then they was smiling, then they was kissing. Now, I think I'm four more pictures away from ecstasy, if you know what I'm saying. Oh, the guy in the middle, that's the guy from Happy Days. I met him. Got his autograph and everything. Potsy. The people was dancing, they was laughing. If that party got any crazy, I bet you Rick James would have walked right through the door. Look at this party. These pictures here, I'm keeping forever. They make me happy because they remind me, if you relax, you can have a good time, baby, even if you smell like dog shit. See, in the end, everybody got what they was looking for, a little love. And I got what I was looking for, a little booty. You see it in my eyes. It's my booty look right there.
The city streets are dark and cold, along the huts about to unfold. The neon lights are flashing by, a stranger's voice is whispering why. We'll never stop, we'll never give in. Our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing until the end. A rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We're driving down the open road, our spirits high, our passion glowed. We're chasing dreams that seem so far. We're raising hell like shooting stars. We'll never stop, we'll never give in. Our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing, we'll keep on playing until the end. A rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We'll never stop, we'll never stop. We'll never stop, we'll never stop. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. Music echoes like a thousand guns.